Good morning, students. Today we start our first chapter. Today we are going to discuss about types of chemical reaction. The first type is combination reaction. The other name of combination is synthesis. What is combination reaction? It is a reaction in which two or more than two reactants combine to form only one product. Here is an example of combination reaction. Here are two reactants A and B. They both combine to form only one product, that is AB. So this reaction is called combination or synthesis reaction. Here are the examples of combination reactions. The first example is ammonia. It is only one product. It is obtained from two substances, nitrogen and hydrogen. The next example is preparation of slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is one product which is obtained from two reactants, that is quicklime calcium oxide and water. In this reaction, only one product, that is calcium hydroxide, is formed from two reactants, so it is a combination reaction. The next reaction is exothermic reaction. What is exothermic reaction? It is a chemical reaction in which heat energy is liberated. Such a reaction is called exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction, if we touch the product, we feel hot because of liberation of heat. In this reaction, product heat energy is less than the reactant heat energy. The example of exothermic reaction is respiration. Respiration is a process in which glucose, which is present in the food, is oxidized to form carbon dioxide, water and heat energy. That is what respiration is called exothermic reaction, since it releases heat energy. The next reaction is decomposition reaction. It is a reaction in which only one reactant decomposes to form two or more than two products. Combination reaction involves only one product, whereas decomposition involves only one reactant. Decomposition is just opposite to combination. Here are the examples of decomposition reaction. The first example is ferrous sulfate, FeSO4, which is green in color. On heating this ferrous sulfate compound, it breaks to form three products, that is ferric oxide, Fe2O3, sulfur dioxide, SO2, sulfur trioxide, SO3. The green color compound FeSO4 on heating change into reddish brown in color compound, that is ferric oxide. The type of reaction involved is decomposition reaction. The next example is calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate is called as limestone or marble. On heating this limestone, we get two products, that is quicklime calcium oxide and carbon dioxide gas. This reaction is a decomposition reaction because we get two products and only one reactant. If the product number is more than the reactant number, then we can say the reaction is decomposition reaction. The next example is lead nitrate. On heating this colorless compound, we get yellow color product, that is lead oxide. This is a basic oxide because metal oxide is a base. Along with that, we get brown color gas NO2 and colorless gas O2 oxygen. NO2 gas is nitrogen dioxide gas, which is brown in color. In this reaction, three products we are getting from only one reactant. So the product number is more than the reactant, so it is called decomposition reaction. The other examples of breaking down of silver chloride and silver bromide. Silver chloride breaks to form silver and chlorine gas Cl2, which is green in color. Now decomposition of silver bromide gives silver and bromine gas, which is brown in color. Chlorine is green in color, whereas bromine gas is brown in color. For decomposition reaction, heat energy or light energy is required. Without this energy, decomposition reaction does not proceed. Decomposition is also example of endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction is a reaction in which heat energy is absorbed. In endothermic reaction, heat energy is absorbed, so if we touch the product, we feel cool. In exothermic reaction, heat energy is released, so we feel hot when we touch the product. Decomposition reactions are the example of endothermic reaction, because in decomposition reaction, energy is absorbed.